SaxaVord Spaceport sits in the Shetland Islands, Scotland, on Unst, the northernmost inhabited island. First off, let's talk about the strange name. It's written SaxaVord with both capital S and capital V in the same name. The name derives from two Old Norse words, Saxa, meaning rock or stone, and Vord, meaning watch or ward. So in English, SaxaVord could be translated to mean stone watch or rock ward, which is fitting for its location and purpose. SaxaVord is first fully licensed vertical launch spaceport in Europe. It received its spaceport license from the Civil Aviation Authority, or CAA for short, in December 2023, allowing it to launch up to 30 rockets per year. In April 2024, it secured a range license from the CAA, authorizing it to manage the sea and airspace around rocket flights. This license is crucial for tracking flights and ensuring safety by issuing warnings to clear hazardous zones during launches. It's important to note that each launch requires a separate launch license. The range license is just a broad approval to provide range control services. While other European sites like Andøya in Norway and S-Range in Sweden are also developing vertical launch capabilities, SaxaVord leads as the first fully licensed spaceport on the continent of Europe. SaxaVord launch services. The spaceport is capable of hosting a wide variety of launch missions on rockets with payloads of up to 1.5 tons into sun-synchronous, polar and high-inclination orbits, as well as suborbital flights. But SaxaVord doesn't stop at launch operations. They also support launch partners with other facilities and services. Let's briefly look at these offerings, and then we'll get into which European space startups have signed to launch from the spaceport already. Facilities. Leveraging Shetland's long history with complex industries like oil and gas, SaxaVord benefits from excellent engineering support and logistics. The spaceport plans to feature up to 3 launch pads and 3 integration hangars, available for either shared or exclusive use. These facilities are designed for launch vehicle preparation, integration, payload processing and mating. SaxaVord can manage the preparation for multiple missions concurrently, preventing any operational bottlenecks, even when several operators are on site, which is crucial given the number of launches scheduled for 2025. The spaceport also offers work environment and meeting rooms, support for personnel and guests, and the natural landscape is available when time permits. One point worth noting is that due to a serious anomaly during a Rocket Factory Augsburg first stage test that resulted in the destruction of their vehicle and all 9 engines, the water deluge and fire suppression services need to be seriously upgraded. In fairness, this is an RFA issue, but to avoid disruption at a busy spaceport, SaxaVord needs to ensure serious pad issues like the RFA incident don't reoccur. Despite this incident, the CAA granted RFA a launch license in January 2025, likely with commitments for improved safety at the launch pad. Launch site services. The spaceport offers support through launch missions from planning to debriefing. In addition, logistics services to and from the spaceport are offered, as well as engineering, maintenance, and fueling operations. Range services. Thanks to the unique location, SaxaVord faces no restrictions on launching into sun-synchronous, polar and high-inclination orbits, or for suborbital missions. This allows for direct trajectories ranging from 330 to 75 degrees, without the need for complex maneuvers like doglegs, which are often required at places like Vandenberg or Cape Canaveral. SaxaVord helps its launch partners with required launch licenses, contacting regulatory bodies and providing comprehensive range services that cover earth, sea and air for each mission. SaxaVord Ground Station Network. SaxaVord Spaceport is developing a ground station network as an additional service. Launch providers need to stay in communication with their launch vehicles to receive telemetry and also, if necessary, to terminate the flight. This requires ground stations positioned around the world as the vehicle quickly goes over the horizon and into orbit. Building a network of ground stations around the world requires serious capital, especially for a small space startup that is struggling to launch a single orbital vehicle. Luckily, SaxaVord provides a pay-as-you-go service, pay per minute or per pass, which I take to mean pay per orbit. No capital outlay, you pay only when your vehicle flies. Much simpler, and SaxaVord claims it's 85% cheaper than building your own network. The network consists of ground stations located in SaxaVord, Greenland, Alaska, Finland, Falkland Islands, and even Antarctica. These locations are suitable for low Earth, polar, and sun-synchronous orbits. Most European space startups are choosing SaxaVord. Why? There are a few reasons why SaxaVord is winning the race to host European launch companies. First of all, it's fully licensed. Licensing is a huge issue for space startups. Just ask Gilmour Space or Varda Space. It can take years in some cases to get the required licensing to launch an orbital class rocket. Some countries make it easier than others. The UK has fully licensed a spaceport and, in the case of rocket factory Augsburg, issued a launch operator license to them in January 2025. That means RFA can launch their RFA-1 rocket from SaxaVord whenever they are ready. Space startups burn through cash quickly, as building launch vehicles is capital intensive. A company can be killed by license delays, so it's crucial to operate from a country that values space startups and can quickly approve launch licenses. Existing infrastructure and logistics. RFA has mentioned that the existing infrastructure, logistics, launch readiness, and rapid implementation and a can-do attitude were factors in choosing SaxaVord. Spaceport can be used for testing and qualification in addition to launches. RFA is using the spaceport for testing and qualification of its first stage and rocket engines. The remote location is ideal, as rocket testing is noisy and disruptive activity, which limits the ability of companies to test near inhabited locations. Good location for sun-synchronous and polar orbits. Sun-synchronous orbits are popular with satellite operators. These orbits pass over the same location at the same time each day, which is great for Earth observation and communications. SaxaVord is an ideal location for these orbits, as launch operators have unrestricted access to polar or high inclination orbits. Okay, let's move on to the European space startups that have announced they will be launching from SaxaVord. Rocket Factory Augsburg, or RFA for short. This space startup is most associated with SaxaVord and have made the most progress towards a launch. In January 2023, RFA and SaxaVord announced their launch operations partnership. RFA will have exclusive access to launch pad Frido for orbital launches. This pad will be used to launch RFA-1, their first orbital launch vehicle. RFA has made steady progress in testing and qualification of their engines, and we're on track for a launch attempt in 2024. During a qualification test of all 9 of their engines, one engine exploded, resulting in damage to the pad and the other engines. Despite the fire suppression system activating, it wasn't scaled sufficiently to handle the blaze, which spread to the propellant lines, and all the engines and first stage were destroyed. Fortunately, the damage to the launch pad was less severe. RFA has stated they will be updating the capacity of the fire suppression system, along with building the replacement vehicle, which is already under construction in Germany. RFA received a launch vehicle operator license from the UK Civil Aviation Authority in January 2025, which authorises them to operate orbital rockets from the UK. Without further mishaps, RFA expects to launch their first rocket from SaxaVord later this year. HyImpulse. In November 2023, SaxaVord announced they will be hosting a programme of orbital rocket launches from HyImpulse from late 2025. HyImpulse has carried out an extensive number of rocket engine tests from the Shetlands in Scotland starting in 2021. One controversial note, at least for British citizens, is that the UK provided funding for this German space startup. It gave £5 million to support HyImpulse's suborbital rocket called SR-75, which is scheduled to fly from SaxaVord. In a memorandum of understanding, HyImpulse has committed to 2 flights of its SR-75 suborbital vehicle from SaxaVord. This vehicle has flown from Australia once already. These suborbital rocket flights will be followed by an orbital launch attempt sometime in 2025, rising to full commercial operations in 2030. Orbex. In a surprise move, Orbex, the UK space startup, in December 2024 switched from using their own Sutherland spaceport that's under development to SaxaVord spaceport. This appears to be caused by their attempt to win a European launcher competition, which could award them up to €150 million. They don't have the capital to work on their prime vehicle, build a launch pad, and design a new larger medium-sized orbital rocket called Proxima at the same time. So, it looks like they are discontinuing further construction at Sutherland, at least for now, and using the SaxaVord Spaceport, which exists and is fully licensed already. In this post and the photo, we can see the Orbex team arriving at SaxaVord to prepare and plan for launching the Orbex Prime micro-launcher vehicle from this location. This vehicle is expected to fly from SaxaVord this year, that's 2025. Frank Strange, CEO of SaxaVord Spaceport, said about this partnership with Orbex. "We're delighted to welcome Orbex to SaxaVord. Given the scale of their ambition and the evolution of their offer to include a medium-sized launch vehicle, it makes sense for Orbex to start operations from SaxaVord Spaceport, which is already licensed and in a position to support their upcoming launches." Unquote. Orbex's main site is located in Forres, Scotland. This area includes its headquarters, mission control centre, rocket design and integration facility, and a testing site. This is where its new Proxima medium launch vehicle will be designed and built, along with the smaller Prime vehicles. This larger vehicle will allow them to address a bigger segment of the satellite market, including more lucrative launch contracts, plus ESA contracts as well. Latitude, the French space startup, plans to launch their Zephyr orbital rocket from SaxaVord. Their maiden flight is scheduled for sometime in 2025. Latitude has been conducting engine tests in the Shetlands for some time now in preparation for their launch attempt. They hope to reach 15 flights by 2026 and 40 flights by 2030. Not all of these flights will be from SaxaVord though. They are also working on flying from Kourou, French Guiana, the same spaceport as Ariane 6 uses. Stanislaw Maximin, the CEO of Latitude at the time and now the executive chairman, said, "We are delighted to start working with SaxaVord. Their development philosophy really convinced us and fitted with the development of Zephyr, our launcher. After all, SaxaVord provides us a multi-purpose infrastructure. This will be vital to support the Zephyr launch cadence." Unquote. Skyrora. In 2021, SaxaVord agreed to a multi-launch agreement with Skyrora, the UK-based space startup. This agreement is for the XL rocket. Skyrora are aiming to fly 16 rockets per year by 2030. Skyrora's founder and CEO said, "We have made no secret of our ambition to be the first company to launch from UK soil, so it's really exciting to agree to this multi-launch deal with SaxaVord. We are proud to be at the forefront of space innovation in the UK, deploying our assets and helping to unlock exciting opportunities as part of the new space economy. The UK is a world leader in space technology, and this latest move brings us another crucial step closer to offering a significant space service from our own soil." Unquote. According to the latest news, it looks like Skyrora is planning to launch their XL rocket in 2026, with the potential of launching their Skylark L suborbital launch in late 2025. We'll keep you informed on launch developments for this company and other European space startups planning to launch from SaxaVord. In the interest of completeness, there are a number of other well-known European space startups developing orbital rockets that I haven't mentioned. That's because they are launching from other spaceports. In particular, PLD Space will be launching from Kourou, French Guiana, and ISAR Aerospace will fly from Andøya in Norway. Both these flights are expected in 2025. Okay, that's a wrap for this video. Thanks for watching. Be sure to like and subscribe so you'll see our upcoming videos. We make videos every week covering the space industry with an emphasis on the smaller space startups that aren't covered so well on other channels. See you soon.